A very good morning to all my 6th standard students. Myself Kamima with you. I hope you all are safe at your places. And even I am safe as well. So I'm going to start a new chapter today. Components of food. I think the first chapter is clear to you all. And I hope you all have conducted the question answers in the notebook. Before I start the chapter, I want to discuss some of the important key points of the chapter. The first point, major nutrients of food are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Students, I have told you in the first chapter what are nutrients. The chemical substances present in our food are nutrients. So, what about then carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are immediate source of energy. That means it is the energy giving food. That means we are giving energy from carbohydrates. If we are consuming carbohydrates in a right amount, in the right proportion, that means we are gaining the energy giving food. It is the energy giving food. Fats. Fats are stored in our body and used only when carbohydrates are in short supply. In any case, if we are not consuming carbohydrates in right proportion to our body, then the stored fats in our body will help us. Proteins are needed for growth and repair. It helps in the growth and development, whether it is the increasing of height, it is the increasing of weight and repairing of anything. That means who help us in our body? Proteins help us. Vitamins and minerals are protective food. That means they are protecting us from various diseases growing around. And now the sixth point is balanced diet. It provides all the nutrients to our body in the right quantity. That means if we are having all the nutrients at the right time and with the right proportion, that means we are taking a complete balanced diet. Okay, students, these were the very important key points of the chapter. Now I'll go through with the chapter. I'll start with the chapter. The major nutrients in our food, I have told you, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. See, everything, all these nutrients performs various functions in our body. That means they are having different types of roles in our body. And what are they? According to their functions, we have categorized the food into three categories. First one is energy giving food. I have told you, they are rich in carbohydrates. See, if we are having carbohydrates in right proportion, that means we are having the right proportion of energy giving food. It is giving us energy to work and play and to perform various life activities. And what are the sources of carbohydrates? From where we are getting the carbohydrates? The sources of carbohydrates are cereals, potato, honey, sugar. And there are many more sources also. And the sources of fats, ghee, oil and butter. See, these are the energy giving food, cereal, potato, honey and sugar. और ये हमारी जो body के अंदर fats का काम करते हैं, fat बढ़ाते हैं, ghee, oils and butter. And what is the function? That means they are providing energy, as I have told you. But if you are not taking these things up to an accurate amount, then some kind of deficiency will definitely occur. Then what will be that? Leads to weight loss and weakness. If you are not consuming carbohydrates and fats in a very good amount, then it will lead to weight loss. Especially it happens with children. See, बहुत ज़्यादा fussy होते हैं, कुछ खाते नहीं हैं. They are just fussy. They are just dependent on the Maggi and the junk food. But if they are not having the good amount of carbohydrates, they'll lead to weight loss and the weakness. Bodybuilding food. They are rich in proteins. If you are taking the enough amount of protein, that means we are increasing in our bodybuilding. That means our body is increasing, whether it is the weight, whether it is the height. How? It helps our body to grow. I have told you in the above key points that protein help us to grow and it help us in the repair also. So what are the sources of protein? From where we are getting the proteins? Pulses, milk, egg, fish and soya bean are the sources of proteins. And what are the important functions? Help to build and repair tissues. And what are the deficiency we'll face if we'll not be taking proteins in a very good amount? It leads to stunted growth. See, jo chote bachcho ki age hoti hai, they are increasing their age and they are increasing with their height also. It is their growing age. If they'll not take a sufficient amount of protein in their daily diet, it leads to stunted growth. Unki growth jo hai wo wahi ruk jayegi, thinning of legs. Tangye bahut zyada patli ho jayenge and the most important patchy skin. They'll be having white patches on their skin. I think you have observed in many of the students, in many of the children also, in many of their friends, of your friends, that if they are not having milk in a good quantity, they are suffering with the patchy skin. Their skin is covered with white patches. So you are requested to take carbohydrate, fats, proteins in a very good amount in your daily diet. And the third part is protective food, which is protecting us from the diseases. They are rich in vitamins and minerals, which protects our body from various diseases. And what are the sources of protein? Protective food, vitamins and minerals? Green vegetables, which always children feel fussy to eat. But in our daily diet, we must eat green vegetables. It is giving vitamins to our body. And what are giving minerals in our body? Eggs, pulses and fruits. And what are the functions of vitamins and minerals? It provide growth and increase our health. Woh humari sehat badhane mein kaam aate hain. I hope the concept is clear to you all. I have explained you about the categories of food, that is the energy giving food, bodybuilding food and protective food. I hope the concept is clear. I'll come again. This is the first unit of the chapter, and again I'll come to you after one day with the second unit of the chapter. Okay, students, bye. Take care.